In this video GIE submission, we demonstrate use of an endoscopic submucosal tunneling dissection technique using a novel bipolar radio frequency and microwave power device to perform rectal ESD. In this case, we describe a 57-year-old gentleman who was referred for colonoscopy after positive FIT DNA testing as part of routine screening for colorectal cancer. The patient was asymptomatic, though initial colonoscopy revealed a large 60-millimeter lateral spreading tumor granular type, LSTG, lesion in the rectum. At this time, no resection or biopsy was attempted, and the patient was referred to our center for removal. Given the size, location, and noninvasive pattern of the lesion, the decision was made to perform endoscopic submucosal tunneling dissection with a novel bipolar radio frequency and microwave powered device. To review the Speedboat RS2 device, this novel instrument is the first advanced energy multimodal device designed for endoscopic dissection. FDA approved in August of 2017. The device utilizes a unique design and insulated base with dual energy capabilities aimed to improve precision, decrease complexity, and shorten the duration of submucosal dissection. A detailed schematic of the device is shown here. As you can see, this novel bipolar radio frequency and microwave power device includes a working channel diameter of 3.7 millimeters and incorporates a retractable 26-gauge needle for submucosal injection and tissue irrigation. The bipolar electrodes use energy to divide tissue while minimizing the risk of remote burn to deeper tissue. The microwave field around the edge of the device slowly heats tissue from 60 to 100 degrees Celsius in order to create tissue denaturation and coagulation. Additionally, the instrument blade has an insulated hull to prevent thermal injury to the muscularis propria. Furthermore, the device incorporates an optimized shaft design, enabling controlled rotation to ensure orientation of the hull parallel to the deeper muscle layer. The electrosurgical generator, as shown in the lower right corner, is the platform used to actually energize the device, and is responsible for delivering energy to dissect tissue and coagulate bleeding vessels. Potential benefits of the device and platform include fast and simple setup, predictable tissue effects, reduced need for instrument exchange, improved safety profile for ESD, and decreased procedure times. However, it should be noted the potential drawbacks of this device, which include its large caliber, 3.7 millimeters, which limits the types of scopes the procedure can be performed with, the need for a separate electrosurgical generator, and the uninsulated tip design without hooking capability, which could lead to inadvertent muscle injury and possible safety concerns for lesions with severe fibrosis. In this video, we first demonstrate a 60-millimeter non-bleeding, carpet-like LSTG rectal lesion found approximately 3 centimeters from the anal verge. Image-enhanced endoscopy with narrowband imaging, or NBI, as shown here, illustrates a type 2 non-invasive pattern per the NICE classification. Preparations are next made for endoscopic submucosal dissection, and thermal marking is done to first mark the borders of the lesion. Once circumferential marking is complete, next a heterostart solution is mixed with a 1 in 100,000 solution of epinephrine and indigo carmine. The solution is then injected into the submucosa to adequately lift the lesion from the muscularis propria. As a tunneling method was used in this case, we then create a horizontal mucosal incision at the oral side of the lesion under 30-watt bipolar cut. After this is performed, we then make an additional incision at the anal side of the lesion using 30-watt radiofrequency energy. A summary of electrosurgical settings for each stage of this procedure are shown later in this video. Next, the previous incision line is retraced to facilitate submucosal entry. As you can see in the video, submucosal dissection is begun, noting specifically that the base of the bipolar radiofrequency and microwave-powered device is insulated and resting against the muscularis propria to avoid muscle injury. The knife is moved horizontally using radiofrequency energy to perform dissection, with preemptive coagulation of vessels performed using 10-watt microwave coagulation. Here, we encounter active bleeding at which time hemostasis is achieved. It is important to note that the bleeding point can be coagulated from both sides of the device, given the microwave field. This is nicely demonstrated here as 10-watt microwave coagulation is performed for periprocedure bleeding during this rectal ESD. Next, we determine and check the depth of tunnel, which is close to the oral incision line, prior to completing the endoscopic submucosal tunneling dissection technique. Demonstrated here, you can see the oral side incision, as well as the endoscopic submucosal tunneling dissection that has thus far been performed. Closer inspection of the dissection reveals the tunnel technique from the anal side of the lesion to the proximal or oral side. Here in this video, we highlight the lateral mucosal incision and submucosal dissection to the open tunnel. It is important to understand that this was started from the gravity or dependent side. If the endoscopist begins from the anti-gravity side, the mucosal flap will flip over and make the dissection on the dependent side much more challenging. Here we see a nice overview of the target lesion and illustrate that the target lesion is just hanging down in a gravity-dependent manner from the mucosa left intact. Next, we perform the lateral mucosal incision and submucosal dissection at the anti-gravity side, first by again injecting using the 26-gauge retractable needle with heterostarch solution. After a lift is performed, submucosal dissection is performed again using radiofrequency energy with careful microwave coagulation of underlying vessels. This process is continued until complete dissection is achieved. Again, it remains critical to utilize the effect of gravity to decrease the complexity of dissection and perform radiofrequency cutting. After dissection is complete, a mesh retrieval netting device is inserted to remove the in-block specimen. Upon removal of the lesion, the Speedboat RS2 device is reinserted to perform coagulation of visible vessels under 10 watts of microwave coagulation. After microwave coagulation is performed, this video demonstrates the final appearance of the resection bed created using this novel endoscopic submucosal tunneling dissection technique. Importantly, we can see there are uncharred margins with no evidence of injury to the underlying muscularis propria. Finally, after pinning and fixation of the specimen, we show a rectal specimen measuring 7 centimeters with final path demonstrating a tubulovillous adenoma with negative margins. Highlighted in this summary slide are the electrosurgical settings used for each stage of the rectal ESD performed. For initial marking, microwave coagulation with 10 watt energy was performed, followed by 30 watt radiofrequency bipolar cut for mucosal incision and submucosal dissection. During dissection, prophylactic coagulation and hemostasis was achieved with 10 watt microwave coagulation. Upon completion of the procedure, the patient was discharged home without issue and was doing well at 1 month follow-up. In this video, we demonstrate successful in-block resection of a large 6 cm rectal LSTG lesion using a novel endoscopic submucosal tunneling dissection technique. The device used in this case to perform rectal ESD utilizes a dual energy capable dissection design to perform precise radiofrequency dissection and microwave coagulation for hemostasis. Successful in-block resection of this large rectal lesion with endoscopic submucosal tunneling dissection technique was accomplished in under an hour. Still, long-term data and larger experience with this device, as well as comparison to conventional endoscopic submucosal dissection techniques, should be performed.